Hey, what's up, everybody? You find me cruising west on I-40 at the speed limit, actually, 75. We're in Texas, and I guess this is probably kind of slow for Texas. But I just wanted to go over Apple CarPlay and using ABRP and as a backup using Waze. So what you're looking at right now is a better route planner. And it actually shows you live state of charge. The top is current state of charge. The green means the Bluetooth is live and connecting. And then the bottom, 23%, is our estimated arrival state of charge. And you can see 76%, according to the car, is the actual, you know, car BMS displayed. And that, of course, matches right now. This isn't always the case. ABRP, I'll admit, is a little bit buggy, especially if you switch between Bluetooth apps on your phone. Like, if I switch between car scanner and ABRP, ABRP loses connection to the Bluetooth data from the car, but from the ODB2 reader. And I should say, like, I take you down here. This is the ODB2 reader. Don't worry, I'm still looking at the road. But that's a little plug-in. I call it an ODB2 dongle. They're about $30 on Amazon. And to switch, like, just as a backup, just because I use and love Waze so much, I'll sometimes use Waze. I basically always back up ABRP's navigation directions of the Waze, just because it's so rock solid. And, you know, it'll tell you about, like, traffic situations. Honestly, I don't need to worry about, you know, police reports, but just certainly, like, objects on the road and cars stopped on the side. Like, you know, traffic's just so chaotic these days, so it's really nice to have Waze as a backup. And yeah, so that's pretty much the navigating here. I really like Waze, but of course, if you like Google Maps or Apple Maps or something, totally plausible. We do have plug share in here. It's okay. It's decent implementation in here. And if you look for, if you like zoom out, it'll basically show you like whatever stations are visible in the map at the time. So I think we've got to zoom out just a little bit more. Yeah, to get over here. So zoom into Amarillo. And yeah, so we've got this. This is where we're headed, actually, the Electrify America at Sam's Club. And you could send the directions to, yeah, whatever your favorite navi is. I guess it's really gonna want to send us there, so we'll send the directions back to Waze.
I don't
here.
Have any data to back up why I think it's a good time to start driving, but it is. Trust me.
Yeah, I've got the office guy or business speak business double speak for my Waze voice this morning. What else? What else is kind of cool in here? I'd say that's it. I mean, obviously, charge point, chargeway are here. Electrify America's in here too, and of course you can. It really doesn't. I don't think it does anything really that cool. So I don't end up using it that much. That's about it. ABRP, if you've used it, it will show you some of the stuff up here. So if we say back, and you want to do like a new plan, it'll kind of do a new calculation here. But I'm not gonna go through all that live. But anyway, I really like the implementation. It basically, I'd say it's like a pretty close approximation to Tesla's routing experience, maybe even better, because ABRP, for those who know, it's long taken into account weather conditions, wind, rain. It'll even reroute you due to weather if you want that feature. I mean, I can't imagine why, but like, I mean, I guess if it was snowing or something, or try to route you around storms. Obviously, like in the US, you know, roads are kind of sparse, but maybe that's useful in Europe. I'm not really sure, but yeah, it's a pretty great piece of software. I'm not affiliated with it at all, but I've used it for a while now. I pay the $50 yearly membership fee and for the premium, which just gives you like the live data, all the live data capability. And the thing basically learns from your particular car's efficiency and gives you much more honed in, you know, better better predictions. So, yep, that's ABRP and Waze.